Hi guys! So, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Danielle and I talk about my hair, natural hair, which are locked. And I am also talking about my sarcoidosis condition, which is an autoimmune disease, as well as life and being a graphic designer, entrepreneur, my studio space, etc. Let's get to it. I'm currently approaching the 2 month level of my locks. So if you don't know, I had locks previously, they were braid locks. I had to cut them off because my hair was thinning, like that picture right there. And it was because of the medication I was taking because of my sarcoidosis. Luckily, I realized it was a medication without the doctors actually telling me. They thought it was something else. They're like, no, the medication that you were taking, which was prednisone, it should be fine. It should, if anything, it should help your hair grow. Turns out that was actually the reason that my hair was falling out. So I stopped taking it. And I was also about to start another medication, which was an injectable medication. So it was kind of around the right time to stop taking it as well. Plus I was on a very low dosage, so keep that in mind. Now, I am trying to lock my hair again. Well, not trying, I'm in the process. I'm locking my hair again. Luckily my hair is growing. In this specific spot is where I had the most shedding or loss of hair. So I'm super excited that my hair is growing back and is continuing to grow back. And I'm almost at 2 months. So I started this time, since I had my hair was really short, I'm starting my locks pretty much from baby length. So for my first set of locks, they were braided based off of my hair that was pretty long at the time. So after a while, of course, like it shrunk and everything, but I still had some kind of length. So for me, this is completely new and it's been challenging, but I'm so here for it. I'm so grateful that my hair is growing back and yeah, let's get to it. So, what are the changes that I've experienced, other than growth, of course? Other than growth, I would say a lot of frizz, which comes with the territory. Trust me, I know, I get it. It comes with the territory, but like when you don't have a lot of hair and 99% of it is frizz, you kind of just look like you have an afro. And don't get me wrong, I loved it when my hair was loose natural, but like the whole point of locking is to not have afros anymore. But anyway, so my biggest challenge is definitely the frizz. I have my moments of just saying, whatever, c'est la vie, it is what it is. Then I have my moments of, I'm putting on a hat and no one talked to me. And if you talk to me, like, don't talk about the hat. but yeah, ups and downs, just like everyday life, of course. And now my hair is pretty long, I would say, considering where it was and how short it was. And now because I have a little bit more length in the lock process and the whole locking stage and the baby locks that I have, my go-to style now has been, because of course my hair is pretty short and it has enough length to be able to like group together, but the little woe there, has enough length to be able to group together, but not obviously long enough for me to have very much hang time. You can actually see this clip here, which I loved. I did it as soon as I got out the shower, because of course, once your hair is wet, you have all the length in the world. And then of course, it eventually turned to this. But anyways, with the bit of length that I have, what I normally do when my hair is relatively dirty and I know I'm gonna be washing it soon, I put it into these twists. And so they look like cornrows or really crappy cornrows, but that's because I can't cornrow. I know, I'm one of those girls, but whatever. So I can't cornrow, and so I do like semi kind of flat twisting type of situation based off of how my hair is laid out and the amount of columns or rows that I have. It works out that I have, that I do 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. And so what I normally do, especially when I want to have like a more quote unquote put together look, and I don't want to have like the afro look, let's say if I'm meeting a new client or if I'm just in the mood of not having the fro, if I'm just gonna be by myself and I just don't wanna have the fro, I would normally do this style. And I keep it in for about a day or two. So the reason why I normally do it before I have to wash my hair is because I put a lot of gel in my hair. And so the way I lock my hair is based off of retightening. So it's the interlocking method. So I don't need to use gel or anything like that or any type of products like that when my hair is being retightened. So for me, gel is something that I wanna be able to put in, maybe keep in for a few days, but then be able to wash out. No buildup, right? Anyways, so what I do is, I'll show you in this video here, essentially what I do is I just part my hair, I put in a whole bunch of gel, and then I kind of make my hair almost twirl in itself and kind of redefine that shape or that lock. With the gel, I'm twirling those little locks. I'm kind of defining their shape and their little position on my scalp, because of course, when it's all frizzy, things kind of go all over the place. So I'm kind of redefining my parts. And then with that, I'm able to then start twisting, essentially just overlapping left, right, left, right, left, right. And I do that pretty much throughout the whole head. Sometimes I put little elastics at the end. Sometimes I just leave the ends twisted, depending on how much hair I was able to get in there. Sometimes I put those little like metal caps that you normally see on braids. I put those at the end if I'm feeling fancy. But yeah, so this has been my go-to style. It's been my quote unquote put together style. It's been the style that I've been able to do essentially with my little skills. The back, of course, is a little bit more fluffy and still frizzy, and sometimes I'll put gel to that, but it's mainly for me. The back, I don't see. I see the front, so it's mainly for me. And of course, do little baby hairs if I'm feeling like it. So that's been my go-to style. And my biggest challenge has definitely been the frizz. I have my appointment actually in 2 days, so I'm actually super excited for that. I've had them every 6 weeks since I started doing my hair, so it hasn't been too many, of course. But we're getting there. Slowly but surely, my locks are coming. And this time they're not started with braids or like locks. Like, yeah. But yeah, I'm super excited about the fact that A, my hair is growing, thank you Lord. That B, I'm able to lock my hair, because it could be growing, but maybe it's growing back in patches, but my hair is actually fully growing properly the way it used to before the whole ordeal of my hair thinning out and falling out. So I'm very grateful and very, very thankful for that. And more length to come, hopefully. I think my ideal length, because I didn't even get to that point with my first set of locks, my ideal length would be like to cover my boobies. I want to be able to cover them. So like if, let's say if I was topless, then you wouldn't see anything but the hair covering them. So that's like my go-to length. I don't think I'd ever want to go to like waist length or bum length. That's just too much. And even then it's pretty long and the weight and all that kind of stuff. So my ideal length would probably be, if you want to put it into terms, probably bra strap length, but one step at a time. So I will see you guys later. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.